In today's fast-paced world, AI tools like ChatGPT have become our go-to assistant. They can write essays, generate code, draft emails, even spark creative ideas. But here's the big question. Are we using it the right way, or letting it silently dull our thinking? The problem isn't ChatGPT. It's how we use it. MIT Media Lab ran a study. They asked students to write essays using different tools. Those who used ChatGPT had a lower brain activity, less engagement, poorer memory recall. But the students who wrote by hand, their brains lit up. More connectivity, better critical thinking, deeper satisfaction. Why? Because thinking, like any skill, needs regular exercise. If we let AI do the heavy lifting, our mental muscles start to weaken. The real risk isn't using AI. It's using it without thinking. It's when you skip understanding, skip questioning, and skip learning. That's when we stop growing. Tools like ChatGPT are a brilliant brainstorming partner. They can list 10 campaign ideas, 5 story hooks, or 3 code structures. But the magic happens when you take those seeds and grow your own tree. AI can give you summaries. But what about understanding? That's our job. Read beyond the response. Cross-check it. Debate it. Ask, do I really get this? Because comprehension is the foundation of wisdom. If you're coding, writing, or solving problems, don't just ask ChatGPT for the whole answer. Break it down. Guide it one piece at a time. The way you understand every decision, every line, every logic. Collaborate with AI. Don't outsource your brain. Here are a couple of use cases. If you're trying to write a leave request email, don't just say, "Write a leave request email for me." Instead, think about the tone, details, your relationship with the recipient. Ask ChatGPT to help with the draft. Edit the words. Make it sound like you. Ask it to write more politely or more confidently. Learn better phrasing for the next time. Use ChatGPT as a writing coach, not a ghostwriter. Here's an improved version. Can you help me draft a friendly and polite leave request email to my team lead for 3 days, June 25th to 27th, for a family event? Mention that I'll coordinate with my colleague to ensure the work continues. And here's the output. It looks great, but still, you can make it yours. Now you can add your personal touch. Add a line like, "This is a pre-planned event I've been looking forward to." Or, replace "hi" with "hello" if your office tone is more formal. Maybe mention the colleague's name if the clarification helps. So this improves the overall answer that ChatGPT provides, and it can always be more customizable. The second use case, for coders writing a Python to-do app. Instead of asking ChatGPT to build a to-do app, do this. Define the parts, add, delete, view tasks. Ask ChatGPT to write one function at a time. Understand the output. Integrate and test each step. Add your own logic. This way, you own the code. You're not just using AI. You're coding smarter, faster, and better. To truly harness the power of ChatGPT, follow these best practices. Be specific. The more context you give, the better the results. Verify everything. Don't take AI at face value. Cross-check. Iterate often. Let AI draft. You refine. Ask again and make it better. Don't blindly copy. You lose understanding and risk errors. Use it as a partner. AI is the assistant. You are the lead. Prompt smart. Think hard. Stay in charge. The real future isn't humans versus AI. It's humans plus AI. The winners will be those who think clearly, prompt wisely, and build boldly. Your thinking into AI is the new superpower. AI can amplify your work, but it cannot replace your vision, your clarity, or your voice. The question isn't, should I use ChatGPT? The real question is, are you using it or not? Make it your tool, not your crutch. Like, share, and subscribe for more tips on mastering AI tools the smart way. Because in this AI era, the thinkers will win.